all about the edge. Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Dude. I'm yelling. Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Dude Ranch DIY.
There we go. Inside voices.
I'm Jake.
And I'm Chris.
This is Chris. We are out here in the wood yard. If you saw the last video, I tested out the new 500i. Pretty immediately found a nice big nail. I told Chris this morning when we got into work.
Yep, metal magnet for life.
Yep,
now.
He called me the metal magnet. So that was unfortunate. I ended up sharpening it, I think 18 passes per tooth, took down the rakers a little bit because I sharpened it so much. So hopefully it'll be back to cutting good. But you know what? We were going to cut today. Chris brought, your Husky
576 XP.
576 XP, and we were going to do a little 500i 576 XP comparison. But we realized, well, let me show you. I'll flip the camera around. So we realized, or I realized yesterday actually, cutting up some of this ash with the 500, is that I got all of these cutoffs and cookies and stuff that just needs to be split. We have a lot of wood coming our way in the next couple weeks. I'm gonna leave it at that, but we are expecting a lot of ash, and it's gonna be ready to go in more ways than one. So we need to make some room here, and getting these cookies and the offcuts and everything out of the way and just split up into chunks so I can burn them in my stove is kind of a priority. I'm on my last tote. I only had 4 totes of the chunks and everything from over the summer because I was giving it all away. And then I had the bright idea to burn it in my own stove because you can't get high in your own supply. So I don't want to be using nice firewood in my stove, so we're going to use all the nasty pieces. So we're going to split up all this stuff. It's going to be tough because we don't have the conveyor or a catch tray table on the end of the splitter, but we're going to try and make it work, huh?
Yeah, this is going back to our roots, back at the original wood yard, no table, yeah. No conveyor, cutting on the ground. It's going to be a great time.
So, you know, we actually weren't going to film, and I just split the first piece, and then I looked at Chris, and I was like, no, we got to film. First rule of theater is always be recording, or first rule of cinema.
All right,
it's the first rule of cinema, always be recording. So, I don't know. We're gonna record some of this stuff getting split up and put into these chunk totes for me to burn in the wood stove. Let's go.
Thank you.
Well, all right, guys, that is it. We got everything all cleaned up here. All that's left are 16-inch cut-up pieces. All those rounds over there are all gone. We were going back to our roots. No sorting tray, no conveyor or anything, just splitting right into the totes. Nice big chunks. We did manage to get down a IBC tote top to catch most of the scraps there. But as you can see, we were, you know, splitting up some pretty good size chunks there. This is kind of an experiment. I've never split up chunks quite this large before, but we got, you know, I'd say 2/3 of a large tote there, full large tote here, and a full large tote here. So that, thank you for the help, Chris, because yeah, I was getting to that point where I was getting a little nervous knowing that I didn't have any more of these totes split up yet. But a lot of this stuff seemed to be pretty nice and dry.
Yeah, I mean, we've been splitting a lot of ash, obviously. And so all those cutoffs are going to be ash-free, ready to go. And a couple of maple pieces, you can mix them in.
Yeah, mix them in, it'll be fine. I mean, for the most part, the stove never goes out unless Sarah and I, like, go away for the weekend. She's gotten much better this year about filling it up herself. So that's always a good thing. And these larger pieces, like I said, are kind of going to be a little bit of an experiment because I generally used to split these chunks smaller. But what I'm finding is, I mean, they burn great. They were all oak, so that's why I was splitting them smaller. This stuff being ash and maple dries out faster anyway. A lot of it's dry to begin with. And I'd rather bring up less large chunks than more little chunks, if that makes any sense. Because what I'm finding is with the bigger chunks, I can throw two like really big chunks in there to fill up basically the whole firebox. And those will burn hotter and for a lot longer than if I fill it up with a bunch, you know, say like 6 or 8 small little chunks. You know what I mean?
That makes sense, yeah.
Because, you know, there's probably about equal amount of air, but you're talking about surface area and burn time and stuff like that. And when it's, you know, it's been in the low 20s these past couple nights, and we've had the house, you know, steady around 67, which might be cold to some of you, but it's perfect for me and Sarah. Well, Sarah might disagree with that, but
she definitely disagrees with that.
It's good. It's, I call it good sleeping temperature. And although I'm not at the house during the day, you know, you bundle up. It's wintertime. So that's my take on things. We got a, I'm holding the Olight over here with one hand, and then I'm holding the tripod with the other because I don't have my little selfie stick thing. But we got the fire going over here, burning up all the scraps from another tote lid. So these things work out great if you guys haven't been using those. Chris, you're going to have to try the 500i another time.
Yeah,
it's a little dark. I don't think it's safe out.
Probably not.
But now that we made all this room, I think we can really hit the ground running.
Yeah.
Plenty of room for more wood to be cut up and more wood to come in.
Yeah.
So
it'll be cool to have a day of just cutting and just kind of flying through this pile as we're waiting for the splitter to become complete again.
Yeah, Chris sent me over. He's been working already on the conveyor. It looks pretty good. I'm actually going to be going up there tomorrow to help him on the trough and some of the paddles. But he basically already has the motor, tank, pump, and valves all mounted up on the conveyor itself. So that's awesome. But we're going to be cutting up all this ash, and hopefully that conveyor will be right back over there in no time at all. So, as always, guys, thanks so much for watching. We really appreciate it. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Check out all the other videos. We got a lot of stuff going on here. Dude Ranch DIY.
Don't forget to subscribe
if you haven't done so already. If you like the video, give it a big thumbs up. If you got any questions, comments, or feedback, throw it down in the comments section below. But for now, I'm Jake.
And I'm Chris.
This is Dude Ranch DIY. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you here next time.